So welcome back to the next session, that is interview technique, which is again very, very important, right? After having effective CV. So next step is always when your CV is selected by the employer, you have to appear for the interview. So what are the different techniques? What are the interview styles? What are the roles and responsibilities played by the interviewer and the interview? Okay, so that we are going to discuss in this presentation. Before talking about the interview and the technique, just try to understand, for everything you are looking for, to make your career effectively, correct? How you develop your career in your life. So what is career, right? Everyone is understood that what is career? A person's course or the progress. A career is nothing but it's a person's life work. Am I right? A person's life work is a career. What is the career development means? Career development is an ongoing process of gaining knowledge and improving skills that will help an individual to establish a career plan. Am I right? And what is the career planning then? So everything related to each other. You know, if you can see from career to career development and the career planning. So everything should go hand in hand. Correct? So if you are planning also ongoing process whereby an individual sets career goals and identifies the means to achieve them. Because you can see the dreams you have aspiring that I want to make the career in this area. But if you are not able to determine and dedicate yourself to achieve those goals, what's the use of your career planning? Correct? So career and career development, your career planning should go hand in hand. So in today's scenario, I have seen many people, have many students, I would say the freshers or the some other people also in that per se experience also, they don't have, they never plan for the future and they follow the crowd, sometimes they choose by influence of others. They choose the career by influence of others. I like my friend is, getting good salary in production. So I have to look forward with the production or PV or CR, whatever, So they choose by, they influence by others. Then accept the parents' verdict. Sometimes by force, parents want to, get their child into pharmacy or hospital, engineering, whichever field. So by force, parents are, insisting them to make the career into this area. And as a person who really wants to make career, suppose a person do not want to make become a doctor, but they have very good artistic mind and they want to go for the art. But because of parent, they have become a doctor and, they are not happy or they cannot provide they cannot satisfy themselves throughout their career. So sometimes I have seen people, they choose the career as per their parents' wish list and then they fail into the career in the later stage. Okay, so better select your career based on your choice, your own aspiration. But see to that you take the advice from others also, because selection of career is very, very important. Okay, so this should happen right from the beginning. And some people get tempted by the current trend. Sorry, IT may, so now IT people are getting very good salary, so I have to move into IT, I have to move into this and that. So have patience, don't get tempted. Looking, the grass is always green on the other side. Okay, some people jump into any kind of career. Then they have lack of motivation, fail to discover their lives and live in a fantasy world. So these are all, today's generation students which we observe. And this is also current trend, focus is lost, effort to increase quantity. So apart from, putting efforts to have better quality, they put, effort into increasing quantity. Then survival of the fittest, then this is also a major trend I have seen. Less influenced by parents, teachers, etc. increasing dropouts. You can see there are many dropouts because they don't pay attention when the studies are going on. Then checking quality in products such as food and clothing, but not in education. So even we have seen people spend money to buy pizza, to watch movie in the theaters, to buy branded shoes, branded clothes. But if they have to pay 10,000, 20,000 for to get them certified, they will not, you know. So that is also one of the trend. Then the increasing competition also demotivates them. Then efforts to increase quantity rather than the quality. So these are all endless process, you know. These are the current trends which I wanted to highlight. Then you should see who are responsible for, you know, student themselves. Why they have lost the focus? Why they are, not sustainable into this competitive world? So they have to think themselves. They are, student themselves are the responsible. And sometimes parents, you know, parents also are responsible because though they are not giving proper advice, or maybe it is reverse also. Even though are trying their best, the children are not listening to them. This is also parent-children relationship is also very important. And because of this generation gap, the world is changing fast. They don't listen to their parents, which I have observed, you know. Not all, but in some homes, you know, we have seen there are many stories. I will tell you this later. Then the society, okay, the government, people who have the knowledge, people who achieved success, but forget others. People who can influence others for good. So these are all responsible for, you know, the career. So what then do we do? What then do we do, right? So people then select what the rest of your life, either you become doctor, engineer, painter, cricketer, right, teacher. So you select your career accordingly. Why select a career? Because we have been created a unique person on this earth, right? Example, fingerprint. See, each person has a different fingerprint, correct? So you are the unique person. Utilize your time, right? We are born only once. So we spend almost 40 years on our work, and a total over 80,000 hours we work. So now ask yourself how you will spend these 80,000 hours before you die. How you utilize this most precious time, correct? And that's the reason career is important. So plan your career from the day one, correct? To obtain great confidence by setting and achieving a goal. Improve your job prospects and employability skills. Take charge of your own destiny, okay? Some people say it's mere naseeb mein hi nahi, it's not in my destiny, but it's not that. It is up to you to go to that destination. I always tell, keep remembering those, you know, 2P and 4D, right? 2P and 4D principle. The first D is what? Desire, dream. The second D, determination, dedication till you reach your destination. So desire, dream, determination, dedication, destination. These are 4D. And 2P is what? First P is passion. You should have passion to meet your aspiration, right? To achieve your goal. And at the same time, you have to have patience, right? So 2P, 4D principle will be helpful to build your good career in your life. But see to that you invest your time wisely to make your career decision, you know. And this career decision making progress, there are 5 levels, right? Discovering yourself, exploring options, making a decision, evaluating the decision. We'll see one by one. Step one is what? Discovering yourself. As I always say, you know better yourself, right? So what are my interests? What are my values? What are my skills? Personality preferences? What are my strengths? What are my weaknesses? What are the 3 careers that interest me? Right? What are 3 college majors, you know, that I want to explore? So discover yourself. Ask questions to yourself first. This is the step one, right? So while discovering yourself, work value inventory, right? So the physical value, the organizational values, and the psychological values. So these three important values you have to keep in mind, okay? Physical values means what? Accuracy, cleanliness, continuous improvement, efficient use of money and materials, maintenance of equipment, right? And so on. Organizational values means what? Accountability, communication, cooperation, coordination, discipline, freedom, innovation, and so on. Psychological means what? Commitment, creativity, decisiveness, determination, harmony, humility, integrity, right? Pleasing others, resourcefulness, respect for others. So you can see tolerance. So these are very, very important values for which we are born, correct? So the important values I have tick mark, you know, determination, humility, integrity, and resourcefulness. Then what? Respect others and tolerance. These are six important skills, the values one should have. The next step is what? Exploring options. So what information or individual can help me to explore my college or the career options? What classes or activities can help me to develop my strengths? How can I learn more about informational interviews, job shadowing, exploratory internship, service learning, civic honors, or student organization to gain first-hand experience? Correct? So these are the exploring options. Now, suppose if you are already in industry, you are experienced. How do you explore the other options? Tell me, how do you explain? You will see how I can enhance my knowledge, how I take the advanced knowledge, how I make my career better than the current one, right? If I am working in analytical, how I improve my skills in the analytical area. If I am handling HPLC and GC, how I can improve my skills in handling, you know, the high-end instrument, which will be helpful, how I can detect the impurity level, correct? So, there are so many advanced techniques, advanced knowledge, or advanced courses are available. You see to that how you can learn while earning. Right? So, from freshers to experience level, you have to introspect you have to explore discover yourself, explore different options, and then make the decision. Right? So, how much time and energy am I willing to invest to make the career decision? Who is part of my support system to help me evaluate the pros and cons? What are my top priorities to consider for the decision? So you have to consider these three steps, okay? Then take the action. How you take the action? How can I strengthen my readiness for success in a, you know, college major or, you know, if you are already into a profession, so what kind of readiness, the advanced knowledge, which will help you for the further successful steps to make the, you know, to go forward with the next career ladder. Now you are at assistant level, like assistant manager. How I can promote to the manager or the general manager, right? So what are the qualities required? So in that respect, you have to think about yourself. Discover your qualities. Do I have the leadership quality? Do I have the team management skill? Do I have can I handle the situation where the contingency approach has to be evolved, right? Can I take the risk? So how the risk is evaluated? So all these things should come to your mind while, you know, going forward in your career. And what is one goal that I have? So some people tell me, like during interview, I want to see myself at managerial position 5 years down the line, okay? So, but how you are going to reach that level? Have you decided what is your goal? What action you are going to take? That you have to decide. Which one of my talent can I develop through classes or the outside activities, right? So there are hundreds, thousands of classes, certification courses are available to achieve your goal in your mind, right? So please think yourself, discover your qualities and potential and develop your skills over the period of time, okay? But please take the decision and action in time. then evaluating the decision. Is my decision a realistic option? Is there anything preventing me from achieving this goal? What would it mean if I didn't have any barriers? Am I right? How you evaluate? With these three questions, you ask yourself three questions. Who in my support system can assist me with achieving this goal? Say, for example, if you want to do MBA along with your PhD, how difficult it would be, just say, after graduation, you are doing PhD, which takes 3 to 5 years, but you, at the same time, you want to do MBA also. So is it possible taking two or three degrees? So additional degrees or additional MBA will also, you have to spend money, you have to spend time, and you have to dedicate yourself. So how you evaluate yourself and how you take the decision, that is up to you. So always think about those 5 steps and go ahead. Then there are SMART goals. Okay, SMART goals means what? Be specific, measurable, achievable, and realistic. Right? S for specific, M for measurable, A for achievable, and R for realistic. And T is for what? Timely. Correct? So these are the SMART goals which you have to think about. How you think about specific means what? State exactly what you want to accomplish. So be specific. Measurable means what? Use smaller mini goals to measure progress. Achievable, make your goal reasonable. As I said, if one person want to do PhD also and MBA also, it's not going to help, right? See to any achievable goal, keep in your mind, right? Then make it realistic. Set a goal that is relevant to your life. And timely, of course, time is extremely important factor because you have to give yourself the time. Time management is extremely crucial because everyone has 24 hours, right? So how you spend those 24 hours, it is up to us. But set a deadline for each and every action or each and every goal which you will decide in your life. Okay? So these are some tips like during your selection of any course or any additional degree, you should see to your better family life. You should see you are helping the nation. Develop skills, motivation, plan intelligently, improve reading, taking notes, which you can use. Okay. So these are tips out of my experience. And this is how the career planning looks like. This is the career planning flow and stages. You can see at the age of 20, you just start, exploring for the jobs so that you feel safe and secured, So the needs for this is what? Safety, security, and physiological. When you are 25 years old, you think of, establishing yourself. So that time also you feel that you should be safe and the secured job, correct? And when you are at 40, you looking for the advancement, like you see, I have reached up to assistant manager. Now I have to advance my career. I have to achieve something else in the society, in my company, right? And that is why you are looking forward with, additional courses or additional training, additional achievements, to have a good esteem and autonomy in your career. Then when you reach up to 45, you start maintaining, your life because you have achieved by that time and actual esteem, actualization will start till you retire, right? So from 55 to 65, people think about the retirement and that is your self-actualization, okay? So these are the, career planning to career goals. Everyone has to go through this flow or these stages, I would say. And these are the references from where I bought the data. Now your actual topic will start, which is interview technique, So I need your kind attention for this. So what is an interview? Everybody knows, right? What is an interview? When you split the word interview, you get two words, right? You get two words, inter and view. And this roughly translates to between view or seeing each other, right? This means that both the groups involved in an interview get to know about one another. Very simple definition. Interview means between view and seeing each other. Correct? An interview is an answer to know and ascertain how to fit a person to the required job. So I always say that you see your capability, your suitability, how you are going to fit for the purpose, fit for the job or the duty, right? And this interview is beneficial to both the candidate and the organization, for it helps them to grow. Okay? So it can be defined as a formal meeting, right? Interview means a formal meeting between two people where the interviewer asks questions to the interview and to obtain the information about the interviewer. And there are no simple interviews, as interviews can take on various different forms and can fulfill a variety of goals. Correct? So when you think of an interview, chances are you imagine a candidate having one-on-one in office interview, right? One-on-one in office interview. So everyone will like to meet face-to-face, right? One-on-one means what? Everyone would like to have interview face-to-face, which will have good impact, which will show the effectiveness, correct? But now due to COVID pandemic, lots of interviews are happening through what? Telephoning or the video calling. So there are group interviews, informational interviews, phone interviews, and many more, right? So in order to nail your interview, it's important to identify and prepare for the specific type of interview you will be engaging is to the maximum your chance of success. So everyone would love to appear the interview successfully, right? And they prepare themselves so that they have job in their hand, right? They feel that if I appear for the interview, I will get this job. So build that confidence in mind and go for the interview. So, there is always a fear factor, right? I've seen many people are they always afraid of, you know, if I'm not selected. They think negatively, if I'm not selected, what will happen? If they ask me such type of question, suppose if you have hidden something, the organizational history, or if you have failed, or you got the ticketing, or you are the dropouts, you start thinking negatively, you know, if the employer asks me such question, what will happen? So don't think like that. Think about your positive, qualities, the strengths, your achievement, and so on. Okay. So what is going to happen during the interview? That is one fear factor, right? Who is conducting the interview? That is another fear factor. What is the interview intended to accomplish? How long will it be the interview last? Where will the interview be conducted? How will I be evaluated? Right? So all these fear factor, how you can search for and how you can prepare for it, knowing I am ready for my interview. So you know yourself about all these answers to this question, right? So you prepare yourself for these questions so that there will not be any fear and you will face the interview confidently. Okay. So the confidence is what? Knowing I am ready for my interview. Right. So that's how you should face the interview. Then there are types of interview, as I said, telephonic interview, right? A phone interview will be an employer's second point of contact after email communication. Correct? So once the CV is shortlisted, which you have already written effective CV, the employer will send the email communication first. And it is not uncommon to have multiple phone interviews before being invited to an in-person interview, right? So what are the phone interview tips? So when there is a telephonic round, you have to prepare your checklist, okay? Create a checklist. Then whenever you are going for the telephonic round, see to that the room is clear and there will not be distractions. There will not be any noise. People will not be around you, right? So clear the room of distractions. Have a pen and paper handy for the note. If the time is not convenient, ask to reschedule. Sometimes what happens, there is an emergency or somebody is hospitalized at your name, but ensure that you inform to the employer that it is not possible due to genuine reason and you can reschedule your interview. Okay. Then turn call waiting off. Okay, turn call waiting off. If possible, use a landline instead of a cell phone. Okay, but nowadays cell phone are preferred. Nobody uses the landline. Correct? Keep your resume in clear view. Keep your resume in clear view. Alright? Then, again, the next type is video interview. Correct? A video interview helps an employer note a candidate's mannerism, preparedness, and appearance more comprehensively than during a phone interview. Correct? So, video calling interview is extremely important because employer would like to see your manners, your behavior, your confidence, you know, because you could see to each other via video, right? So when you are going to have a video interview, do take a trial run before the interview. Set up your camera and any headset or the microphone ahead of time. The ideal background is tidy, distraction-free, quiet, and well-lit. So light also is very important, right? You have to dress professionally. Avoid making hand gesture, which can stutter on the screen. Okay? So employers are also increasingly relying on pre-recorded video interviews where a candidate records themselves answering interview questions. So this has become now very popular during this COVID time. Okay. Then in-person interview, which is age-old technique, correct? And which is, of course, a very fruitful technique because you are going to the employer office and you are, you know, actually interviewing. Okay, you are actually talking to them, you are meeting them, handshaking, maintaining eye contact, and so on. So this type of interview consists of candidate meeting with an employer, usually in the office, and in person an employer will be able to see if you really want the job, as they will be constantly monitoring your enthusiasm about the role. Remember, an employer wants someone who is passionate and not just looking for a paycheck. Correct? Sometimes I have seen people just send their resume and keep quiet. They don't follow up. They don't. Is their enthusiasm level also will be checked, no? If you are continuously writing them, following up with them, then employer will also think that, yes, this person is in the need of job. Correct? So there is always a give and take. When there is a demand, there will be a supply. Correct? So always think about this. Think of question to ask. Dress to impress. Means you have to professionally, of course, dress. Prepare for common interview question. Bring interview materials. Research the company and read the job description. So these are the tips which I have given on the right-hand side. Then the group interview. Okay. Why the group interviews are important? Again, there is a fear factor. But for the employer, it is very important technique to select the best person among the group. Right? So group interviewers are also very popular when they want to select an appropriate candidate at a little bit higher or the middle management level. Okay. Because they get the multiple candidate who can come together for the interview. And these are extremely important, you know, to have the efficient, extremely efficient for the employer, as they are able to vastly reduce the time they spend in interviewing. Okay. So group interviews can be especially challenging for candidates as they tend to be stressful. However, performing well in them indicates to employers that you are able to perform in high stress situation also. So as I mentioned, the middle management or the higher management people are always selected like this because they have to show their leadership quality, you know, the preparedness, the confidence, whether they are good listener, whether they effectively communicate with each other or not. You know, so These are the skills required during your group interview. Then the panel interview, right? So panel interviews are a twist on traditional interviews. And panel interviews consist of a candidate being interviewed by multiple interviewers at once, right? So these panel interviews are always at a very higher position, or sometimes to save the time, people sit in the panel, like some one person from technical team, one person from HR, one person from accounts or any other departmental head. You know, in that way, 3 to 4 people are sitting for the panel interview. So just to, find out from LinkedIn who are the people, the interviewer, okay? And engage with all the interviewers, not just most outgoing participant, right? Be prepared for any type of question. Because see, each person is from different background who are sitting in the interview panel. So they may ask any kind of questions. So you have to prepare yourself, okay? So this is like, group interviews, panel interviews are often stressful, showcasing to employers how well you will perform under pressure. And panel interviews also show employers how well you can navigate group setting and handling the different personalities. Am I right? So this is also very important. Then come to your main job interview, right? So the most crucial 30 to 60 minute opportunity you have in your job seeking efforts, right? So the culmination of all your preparation, including your education, the key to opening the doors to your career, and your goals for effective job interviewing, get the job offer, land a stimulating and rewarding job. Interviewer's goal in effective job interviewing is what? Can you do the job? Will you do the job? Will you wait along with the other employees? Correct? So these are the question which will be, interviewer's goal. So I'm just think from both the end, right? So you are going for interview, but there are interviewers sitting who will be having this type of question. If you are able to think about what will come to their mind, and you prepared for those answers, then sky is the limit for you, okay? So what I mean to say there, like along with your personality, own skills, experience and achievement, you have to think from interviewer's point of view, who are the interviewer, what they are, at what level they are, and you can search from your LinkedIn and other social media. Information, how during audit we find out the information about the auditor. Okay. Then what is the interview strategy? You have to plan, perform, right? Prepare yourself and progress. So have advanced knowledge of the company and the answers to the fear factor question. Right? Know what the interviewer is asking and trying to discover about you. Be prepared to convince the interviewer. You can accomplish his 3 goals, right? What? You can see the 3 questions behind. Can you do the job? Yes, I can do the job, right? Will you do the job? Yes, you will do the job. You will get along with other employees? Yes, you will get along with the other employees, right? So most interviews are pleasant and friendly. Try to enjoy it. Because see, I have handled more than 1,000 interview, and I always observe the body language, eye to eye contact, handshake, and how the confident person is who is coming for the interview. Okay, but at the same time, we ensure that we make them very comfortable. We don't ask question which will lose their confidence. We also try to keep the environment healthy, very friendly. So that a person coming for interview will build some confidence, and he try his level best to answer perfectly. Okay, and these are some interview strategy, like make eye contact at least 1/2 to 2/3 of the time, not every so often. Okay, smile even if not in mood, fake social generosity, be be careful about oversharing, that is disclosing too much of information. Check your impulse to use other person's name repeatedly. Never use first name in interview. Okay, so in US style they generally use first name, but in India, if you see, we always see to that you use the second name. We always pronounce with the surname, right? Mr. Patel, Mr. Khare, or whatever. And then radiate accessibility, show interest in others, match speech cadence, right, to other person, listen closely. So listening skills are very important, which will you will be a successful in any interview, because you have to listen to any question asked by the interviewer very carefully, very carefully. If you don't understand, please you ask them to repeat. But don't assume that you listen to some other question and you are answering. Oh, I thought you asked me this. Oh, I thought, I assume that. Don't ever use such type of words. Okay? So listen to them carefully. If you not understood the question, ask them to repeat. There is no, not to worry. Don't hesitate to ask the question. But don't take the person's name repeatedly, or don't irritate them. Okay? So these are some tips which are very important during the interview strategy. And think like the interviewer. Right? Think like, if you would have been the interviewer, what you would have been asked. If you are the employer, how you can select the employee which suits to your purpose, right? So that way, if you start thinking, half the battle will be won, right? So always think like the interviewer. What does the interviewer want to know? You are the best person to accomplish his or her three goals, right? You will not become his or her worst fear. You will make the company better. The manager's life easier. The manager become more successful and look better. What kind of question will the interviewer ask? All interviews are different. My dear friend, all interviews are different. Don't think that last time he asked the XYZ question, so same question will be repeated. Of course, there are some basic questions like, tell me about yourself. And there are a couple of other questions like, what are your strengths, weaknesses? These are typical questions being asked to the freshers and, the 1 or 2 years experienced people. But don't think that every interviewer will ask this question. Okay? So most interviews are routine. There are some routine questions you can expect. But areas the interviewer needs to know about: your education, your experience, your general intelligence, your skills, attitudes, and personality. So there is a STAR concept, okay? The STAR interview technique. What is STAR? Is a S for situation, T for task, R for result, right? A for action. So situation, task, action, and result is last. I wrongly said the word. Okay, so first is situation, task, action, result. So always think about what kind of, you should be in a position to describe by taking the help of STAR concept. Okay, so each of the word connotes an experience that an interviewer can call back to while being faced with qualitative or quantitative interview question. And this STAR technique is a great way to structure your thoughts and responses when formulating an answer to an on-the-spot question. Okay? Suppose if you, the question asks like, suppose there will be a natural calamity happens and your office is closed for 1 month. Okay? There is a flood and 1 month office is closed down. Then how you will handle this situation? So normally, if you are at head of the department, so you should be in a position to answer by taking this help, right? Define, describe the situation. In this situation, how you are going to handle those tasks, provide the details of your responsibility, how you are going to handle the team. during this natural calamity, when there is hardly any access to server or any access to document, how you are going to, so define step by step how you are going to achieve those, how you are going to demonstrate, how you are going to take the action, okay? Because you are in charge of the department and whole system is collapsed, how you are going to recover everything, and how the results will be shown. And that will be a lesson learned from your end, and explain the impact and that you made, the impact you made or the lesson you learned. So this is an extreme case which I quoted the example, but in your life, just think about the example, to quote by using the STAR method. Okay. So situation, task, action, and result. Suppose I will quote one more example. Like there was a deadline given for submission of ANDA, okay, regulatory submission to USFDA. Suppose the deadline was given and per year you had given 30 ANDA to submit. Now per year 30 ANDA was the task. It's a big task and you are handling a team of only 5 people and there are 30 ANDA per year. It's a very difficult, it's non-achievable target. But if you plan a strategy, you develop a strategy, you train your employees, your team members perfectly to avoid any error and get the work done, in time, then it is very good. You can achieve all 30 ANDAs to submit, by the end of year. Suppose the year starts in January and ends in December. And you can very much, but suppose if it is not achievable target, you can ask support, the manpower, additional manpower from the employer. Okay, if you are suppose stuck up due to some external laboratory testing or something else, goes wrong. So you can buy a time or buy additional resources who can deal with the external laboratory testing, correct? So suppose if you don't get DMF in time or if you don't get the stability data in time, what will the question coming to your mind? So you have to define all the pros and cons and you are answerable how you are going to tackle those, all different activities with the less manpower and 1 year in hand. Okay. So the time is very important to achieve those results. So keeping goal in mind, always think about in what situation you started, what kind of activities you have provided and what action you have taken, which has the good result, which have the good impact and the lesson learned in your life. Okay. So job interview, you have to prepare, like, tell me about yourself. These are the common questions which I explained earlier. In what ways will your education or training help you in this position? Why did you specialize in your particular field? Tell me about a problem you solved on your previous job. Correct? So you have to keep some kind of information ready, some kind of case studies. As I mentioned, the example of, this ANDA submission, the deadline. So there could be several examples in your own career. So keep ready those case studies in your mind. Provide information whenever it is been asked. Okay, how you handled, what kind of action you have taken. So you should demonstrate your capacity to make the practical application of formal knowledge and the training. Right? In what ways will your education and training help in this position? So you should be able to demonstrate. Then what are your biggest strengths? Correct? So the interviewer typically asks this question to see the areas where you are most confident in. Correct? However, you have to be able to find the right balance between showing belief in yourself and not seeming overconfident. Sometimes you say, yes, I'm a very creative person. I'm very versatile. I'm very flexible, focused, talk all the qualities. Correct? So see to that, you explain with the case studies in your mind for each quality, for each scale, you should have at least one example to quote. Okay. when they ask about your biggest strength, you should be in a position to demonstrate those particular skills, the strengths. Okay. When they talk about the biggest weakness, like self-criticism, you are insecure, too detail-oriented, your public speaking skills, you are poor in public speaking, or you have poor presentation skill, like that. If you think that you have various shortcomings, that you have and that you are willing to work to overcome, they shouldn't be directly linked to the responsibilities of the job you are applying for. Correct? Suppose if you are hiring for a RA position or the medical device expert, and if you say that, I really am very poor in handling deficiency, I'm very poor in handling regulatory submission, that is my weakness, then you are gone. Right? You are gone. So don't link those weaknesses that you will be rejected. Okay? So here, on the right-hand side, if you see, these are the strengths and weaknesses. I have quoted a few examples. You can add based on your own experience. Okay? So something, the biggest strength can be found in how you understand and confront your greatest weaknesses. Correct? Then these are all typical questions I brought for you. Like, these are, what are your hobbies? How does this position fit into your future plans? Where do you see yourself in 5 years? Right? So you have to demonstrate your ambition, your potential, and the flexibility. Do you prefer to work alone or do you prefer to work as a part of a group? So double-edged sword. Okay, work alone could be self-starter. Work in a group could be a team player. So stress both attributes. So you should demonstrate that given an opportunity, I prefer to work in a team, okay? But I'm fine even an opportunity to work alone, I can handle independently. So both ways you should be able to tell them, the exact what you are looking for, the qualities. And when they ask, where do you see yourself in 5 years? So really think about what you want to get out of the job and where you want it to take you in your career, right? Be honest about your goals, but make sure they align with the job plus the company, correct? So always show you are very ambitious, align your goals with the company's goals, be creative but realistic, show your passion towards the path ahead of you. Then the next question, like, what do you know about our company? Of course, you have researched, before you appear for the interview. Correct? Then why are you interested in working for this company only? So relate your skill to what you know about the company. The best answer is typically one that underlines the company's strength and how they can help your career. Correct? What is your motivation for doing a good job? So mention an internal or external factor that keeps you motivated to perform and to succeed. So, in a job, what interests you most or what interests you least? When they ask, relate to your position, okay? If you are at managerial position, you relate what interests to you and most means. And what if please describe your best and worst boss? Keep it positive. I always tell my student, never utter a single word about your previous boss, though it would be a very bad experience for you. Okay, always tell positive about previous organization. Sorry, and the previous bosses. Then give me one good reason I should hire you. This is a typical question asked. Because, of course, you have to demonstrate your ability that you are fitting for the job. You are suitable for that particular job. And that is why, the employer should hire you. Then what qualification do you have for this job? identify your key strength related to job description, correct? Provide evidence of strength utilization as demonstrated in major contribution and job success. So how are you best fitted for that job? You have to demonstrate. Are you a team player? This is also a typical question, because nowadays in every company you will see there is a work or the project assigned with multiple people. So you have to always work in a team. Correct? So are you a team player? Do not only answer with a yes, but also give an example. Okay? Or explain why you can function in a team situation. So always demonstrate that you can work better when given an opportunity to work in a team or a group. How good are you at handling pressure? This is also a typical question, correct? So simply stating that you are good at handling pressure is not likely to convince the interviewer. So the best way to answer this question is by giving examples of situation where you were faced with pressure and managed to handle it. So again, I will quote this example of 30 NDAs per year. You have given the target of submission of 30 NDAs per year with the 5 people. So you are continuously under pressure, but you were able to manage the submission as per the deadline given. So similarly, you can keep a couple of other examples based on your own experience. So this is also a very good question being asked by many, many employees. Then relocation is also the typical question. Are you willing to relocate for work? Because what happens, many companies, if you see Cipla, Sun Pharma, Abbott, they have multiple plants, all over the world. They have presence in 140, 160, 180 countries. So this is also a typical question will be asked, that are you willing to relocate? Because sometimes what happens, they just try to set up one department at one location and they make the transfer of that person from one location to another, another to third. And then he can become a site head for, multiple sites, 2 sites, 3 sites, 4 sites. Then he become a corporate head also, who can handle multiple sites. So if the question is asked like, are you willing to relocate for work? If answer is yes, then you should state so empathetically, right? And if the answer is no, you should be truthful, but also show openness to the possibility of relocating in future. Sometimes, suppose if your parents are ill and you are located in Mumbai or in any other area like Gujarat, and you are unable to relocate because of the reason that your parents are ill, they are cancer patient, there is nobody to take care of. So with genuine reason, you can say that, currently, the situation is such that I am unable to relocate. But in future, of course, given an opportunity, there is a possibility to relocate. Okay. So, don't make a mistake of not asking any question. When it is your turn, the employer has asked if you have any question, any doubt, you need any clarification. Please feel free to ask. So don't make a mistake of not asking any question during or at the end of your interview. You are interviewing them too, right? To see whether they are a good fit. So think about what matters to you in an organization. Your question will demonstrate your preparedness and interest in the position. Okay. So the organization culture, like how would you describe the culture? How do people, espouse organizational values? What do you like best about working here? This gives you an idea how well you will fit in the job, right? Whether the job is, what are the challenges of the job? Why did the last person leave this position? What qualities are necessary for someone to excel in this role? This reveals whether you really want the job, correct? So, and demonstrate your desire to succeed. In the interview process, right? When do you expect to make a decision? What are the next steps? What else can I address about my qualification? This manages your own expectations and demonstrates you want to move forward. And the best is the organization. Can you share your current strategic plan? how does the organization make a positive impact? Is the company growing? This demonstrates your interest in their business needs. Right? Sorry. Then you can ask career development, training, you know. But never ask about the salary, right? Not about salary. The interview is not the time to ask about salary or the benefits that will be discussed at the different time. Remember, show enthusiasm when wrapping up of interview. Okay? You can ask how the employees are evaluated, how will my progress will be measured, what are your expectations for this role, you know, within first 30 to 90 days. In the hiring manager, what has been your own career path, you know, what has led to your success here. This question will be build a relationship with them and you shall learn more about the work environment. Okay. Then these are some tips for the professional dressing for the interview. Nowadays, everyone is aware of the dressing, you know, the professionalism, how you maintain. So this I have given for the women and the men. Okay. So you can see how you have to dress up. Don't wear, you know, the flashy jewelry, earring, you know, watch or bracelet, necklace. Remove all piercing, you know, one set of earring is acceptable. Okay. Then dress shirt or pant, crispy iron, button up. Solid color, right? Then in accessories, see to that purse should be moderate size. Purse should match to your shoes, okay? Then the hygiene, you have to maintain, of course, always hygiene. Don't put flashy deodorant or, you know, the cologne or the perfumes. Maintain fresh breath. Wear light perfume, you know. Then nails should be neatly trimmed. Nail polish should be clear or a natural tone. So similarly, for a man, the tie, suit, you know, the hygiene, hair, dress, shirt, jewelry, footwear will be seen. See to the minimum, you know, and wear professional, you should have a professional look. Then hair is also very important, you know, make it a very simple, conservative style. Get a haircut 3 to 5 days prior to interview. Don't cut your hair on the day of interview. Okay? 3 to 5 days before you should interview. If you want to go for facial or, you know, beauty parlor, then see to that 1 week in advance you should go to the parlor. Then there are some non-verbal communication you have to, you know, keep in mind. These are, you know, do's and don'ts while sitting. You can see these pictures, right? Sit up straight, maintain eye contact, smile, and be enthusiastic. Use hand gesture. Don't slouch, stare, frown, or, you know, fidget. So always offer your hand, use a firm but not crushing handshake. Use your eye contact without staring, avoiding contact, you know, sign of deception. Disinterest or lack of confidence, right? And if a place of sitting is not indicated, choose a chair closest to the interviewer. But sit relaxed, but do not slouch. Learning slightly forward towards leaning slightly towards forward. Show interest, but do not lean on desk or knees. Use hands naturally to emphasize a point. Do not cover mouth, hold your head or twist hands. Correct? But now during interviews, during COVID, see to that you wear mask. Okay, you use hand sanitizer and cover fully your body with a suit. Okay? Professionalism will be seen. Like I have shown the previous slide of how you dress, how you wear the clothes. Now everything is clear up to interview, right? So the main thing after interview also, what you have to keep in mind. So these are the 3-4 slides which are extremely important. please keep your attention, make note, you know. So review and analyze your performance, take notes, modify any items to improve your next interview. Suppose if you feel that interview went well or bad or moderate, note down those points, how it went, you know, whether it was smooth interview or all question you were able to answer or not, how you demonstrated your ability for the purpose. Don't forget to send a thank you note to the manager immediately after the interview, okay? Don't put this off. Make a return visit or a telephone call 2 or 3 days after your interview. Reintroduce yourself and remind which job you were interviewed for. Add any additional thoughts you may not have covered during interview. Emphasize your strength for the job. Find out if a hiring decision has been made. If decision has been made and you are not it, okay, ask for suggestions for creating a better impression. Thank the interviewer for speaking to you and for his time. Right? So how do you write a letter, right? Thank you for taking, hello, write down interviewer name. Thank you for taking the time to meet me, with me today. It was great to learn more about the position, company and the team. I'm very excited about the position and think that I would bring better specific skills, okay, relating to your position. And I look forward to hearing from you about the next step. Thanks again for your time. So this is a post-interview thank you email. Don't forget to write, okay? The next step forward is also extremely important. Don't forget to follow up, okay? So this is an example how you follow up with the interviewer. So write down again later. Suppose if you don't get reply within 1 week, 2 weeks, or if it is a month time, write down a follow-up email, okay? So you can write down, hello, Mr. So-and-so. I hope you have been well since I have interviewed for the job title. Interview date also you can mention. And following up, as your team mentioned, that you would be finalizing a hiring decision this week. So I'm wondering if there are any developments in the hiring process or if there is anything you need from me. Do you need any additional document, additional information? Please let me know, okay? So I will send it right over. Thank you so much for your time. Best regards. So this is also an extremely important letter, okay? So these two slides, you please keep in mind. So last but not the least, invest your time in productive stuff. The key is not spending time, but in investing it. Written by Stephen Covey, right? So everyone has 24 hours and you know better how to invest, where to invest, you know, for your better career. So these are my the principle of 4D and 2P as I mentioned, right? 4D is what? The first D is for desire and dream. Second D is for determination. Third is for dedication. Fourth is for to reach your destination. And in between those two P is what? First is passions. The second is patience, because in order to meet your destination, you should have patience. Okay? So with this, I finish my training on, you know, the interview technique. Okay? So I will take a break for 5 to 10 minutes and then we will cover the question and answer being asked for different position. Okay. Thank you once again for your attention. And it was wonderful to have a discussion with you, sharing my knowledge. Okay. Thank you.